Welcome to QuickBooks Online for Nonprofits. My name is Ufuma Ogaga. I am the owner of Goshen Bookkeeping and Consulting. I am a financial controller and a QuickBooks Pro Advisor, helping nonprofits to increase profitability one mission at a time. In today's tutorial, I am going to show you how to customize your sales forms in QuickBooks Online. To create custom sales forms in QuickBooks, click on the gear icon and select custom form styles. You can create new form styles such as invoices, estimate, and sales receipts by clicking on the new style button. We're going to create an invoice first. Here under the design tab, you need to give your invoice template a name. You can change the template type, so you could choose Airy, Classic, Modern, Fresh, Bold, Friendly. So you could choose any template that matches your nonprofit branding. I like to choose the Friendly option. Once you select the template that you want to use, you can add your logo by uploading a copy to QuickBooks Online. You can change the color of some of the boxes on the template to match your nonprofit's brand color. You could choose a different font type. And you can change the font size as well. You can edit the page margins of the template, so if you want to increase the left, top, the bottom, the right, you can do so. If you want it to be fitted in a windowed envelope, you can check that option. If you do use a letterhead paper for printing out your invoices, you can also check that option. Switching to the content tab, here you can customize the body of your template by clicking on the pencil icon. Under the header, you can update your business information, add your contact information, whatever information is missing on the screen, you can add that. Under the form section, you're going to edit the name of your template. So if you want to call this pledges, if you are tracking pledges inside of QuickBooks Online, you can call it pledges. If you are tracking sponsorships, payments, or invoicing your sponsors, you can call it sponsorship invoice. So you can change it to whatever you want. You can activate the custom transaction numbers, which is the number that shows right next to your form name. You can add a shipping address to display on the invoice if the customer has a shipping address. You can add additional custom fields if you are using those options inside of QuickBooks. Switching to the table section of the invoice template, here you can decide to show account summary on the template. You can customize all of the labels and columns that are displayed, the size of them. Clicking the pencil icon and switching to the message side, which is the footer of your template. Do you want to show the deposits on the invoice, or do you want to show an estimate summary? If you're using the estimate function, Do you want to show deposits or discounts here? You can show that as well. You can customize message that shows up in the invoice. So here you can thank your donors, like thank you for your generous giving, or thank you for your payment, or thank you for your service. So you can customize this message box. You just want to keep it short and simple. If you are tracking payments with a third-party system, you can also put a payment link in this box. You can repeat the same information, that payment link, you can put it in the footer text section, just in case if you're not using QuickBooks Online payment system, and if you're using like a PayPal or a Vanco system or any other third-party merchant processor, you can put that information in the footer text. You can also add your federal EIN number there. If you are using QuickBooks to track your donation statements, you can add your federal EIN number there as well. Switching to the emails tab, here you can choose how your invoice will appear in emails. So you can select the option to choose full details, or you can do summarize details. And if you click on full details, you will see how it looks like on the right hand screen. It's going to show you this is how your email template is going to look like. I hate the full details version, so I usually use the summarize details version because it's very simple. It keeps the email clean. You can attach a PDF to your email. You can change the subject line of your email. You can customize the body of your message. You can also customize reminders as well. The Payments tab gives you the option to select the types of payments you want to collect from your donors, members, entities, and sponsors if you are using QuickBooks Payments. QuickBooks Payments is a merchant processor that allows other people to pay you directly online and through clicking a link on your invoice by credit card or by ACH bank transfer. Now, I do recommend working with an Intuit reseller partner to get better credit card rates for your nonprofit. Here you can select bank transfer or you can select credit card. You can pretty much select the payment method that you want to allow on your invoice. So if you select bank transfer, it will automatically put a pay now green button on your invoice template for the customer to click on it and pay you or send you money. Since the bank transfer option is free and it usually takes 5 to 7 business days for you to receive your payments, that's the option that I typically recommend my nonprofits to sign up for. And you can go through the whole process of creating a profile. So once you do all of that process, you want to click Preview PDF to just see how your template looks like. That way you want to make sure that everything is correct, it matches what you need. I'm going to click Exit to exit that screen, and then just click Done to complete and save the invoice. Here's the invoice templates that we just created in QuickBooks Standard Default 1. I am going to repeat the entire customization process again by creating a sales receipt. If you don't like QuickBooks template, you can import your own Word template by clicking on the gear icon, then select QuickBooks Labs. Here you can select the features that are in beta mode. Turn on import style. You can click on import styles to watch the video, the demo file. You can read more about it. You can also give Intuit feedback to let them know that you either like this function or you don't like it. In this screen, you can also select and turn on other features that you're interested in using in QuickBooks Online. So you go through that process, just click done to exit out of this screen. To import your templates, you're going to click on New Style and then Import Style. You need to download the sample file because it has the HTML codes and feeds that you need to use to customize your template. That is how to create an invoice and a sales receipt template in QuickBooks Online. Thank you for watching.